In the future, I see clean cities, clean surfaces, cities, and the way that we move around the world will change, will be subject to new ideas.
And when it comes to our vehicles, Lovegrove thinks the world needs a major intervention.
I take my son to school, and in one day we counted 72 SUV vehicles. Well, nothing against a mother thinking that she has to protect her children. Why protect our children when the exhaust emissions that come out the back are killing us? So eradicate that, change the fueling system, and clean society up.
It doesn't get any cleaner than Lovegrove's latest concept car.
Car on a stick is this joyful pod that contains four people.
The car's canopy is coated with photovoltaic cells that can convert sunlight into electrical energy, which is then stored in an onboard battery.
I think in the future, beginning now, we have to use whatever surface we can in order to harness some energy.
But the transparent bubble also reflects his distaste for how we move through cities today.
Cars have become this kind of, these big tin cans which isolate ourselves from other people. Why don't we have more transparency? We're protecting ourselves from society. What's wrong with society?
The vehicle is designed to glide along without a driver, using GPS and onboard sensors to drive automatically. But that's not why Lovegrove calls his concept car on a stick. When not in use, a telescopic pole raises the entire vehicle off the road.
It's made from composite materials, which are very, very lightweight.
And that's not all.
It's a car during the day, and at night it's a street lamp.
Imagine a row of Lovegrove's cars lighting the roads from above at night.
I mean, most of the time when I tell people this, they laugh. But in reality, that laughter is a sign that maybe you're touching a nerve in the emotions of people. From solar-powered street lighting, solar trees, to solar-powered cars, to new bubble cars. A lot of these things can exist.